Hey, how's it going, y'all? It's Kashta here with another tutorial for Logic X. I'm gonna walk through and make a quick beat. We're starting off with the first sound. I got a piano. You know, we're gonna just figure out something with that. I got a little line here that I'm using. Monetize it real quick. I'm copying it over so we could just loop it. Now I'm looking for another sound that I can actually use to, you know, complement the one I just did, so. Yep, so I'm gonna go with the horn section and see how that sounds. So I'm basically just playing around until I figure out what I want to do, and then I'll record it. Okay. I'm going to record this so I can get that down so I can start with the next sound. Go down again, quantize it. Copy it over so I can have it for the loop. And I basically just duplicate this same sound so I could just choose another sound. I'm gonna probably move on to the drums now. I had stuff like that. I'm gonna probably put a clap in there first. I'm gonna record the clap real quick. Just a basic clap, just a basic stock sound, just to give you guys an idea just how you know, go about step by step making this track, just how to put a track together quick. So I got the clap. I'll probably do a kick next. I'm just EQing it real quick so it sounds a little bit better. A little bassier. I like kicks to be kind of heavy. Just EQing it real quick. There we go. For the kick real quick. Just something real simple, real basic, real quick. Go down and quantize it again. Yeah. So we got the first couple of instruments. We got part of the drum track done. Beats coming together little by little. So I'm gonna duplicate that. Move that same EQ I just used. I'm gonna use hi-hat now. Basic trap hi-hat, something simple. Quantize it just like I did everything else. Gotta fix that little note real quick. There we go. Put a crash in there. Or a reverse sound or something. I think I'm gonna use a reverse cymbal like that. Open hat right here. digitize that just like I did the rest. Now I'm gonna go to the next sound. I'm gonna use that reverse cymbal that I use. Quantize it just like I did before. Get rid of the extra note. So that basically completes the drum track. Basically, that's about it for the drum track. Trying to see what next we should use. Probably use a bass. Put a bass line in there or something. Use a sub bass. Trying to use all the elements that you need for a complete track, you know. Instruments, drums, bass. We got the drums and the instrument, so put this bass line in there. Basically, I'm just freestyling, figuring out what I want to do as I go. So, put that in there. Yep, so I'm just going to use one half after I quantize it. I don't need to use it all. I could just copy it. Bass, instruments, drum track finished. These are the very basics of what every track needs. Play with some strings a little bit, see what I can come up with. Happy to change the sound for the chorus or something. I'm gonna have at least a couple instruments to divide the chorus and the verse up. Freestyle something real quick, record it. So I'm gonna just take the first half of that, quantize it real quick, and just use that. Something simple. Just looking for just a little lead sound, something for the chorus or something to separate the verses and stuff. Some simple sound. Okay. I like that. I'm gonna use that. And basically, what I'm doing is just freestyling. Once you figure out what you want, you just hit record and go with it. Just quantize it. So basically, that's basically it. Once you get those basic, you know, sounds down, do the drum track, move on to the bass line, and add maybe a lead or something simple to separate the chorus and the verses, and that's basically it. Just building little by little on what you have already, so hopefully this helps you guys out a lot. Thanks.